Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Muy buenos días.
Buenos días.
For the Spanish-speaking people. Guten Morgen, alles gut? That's for the German. Guten Morgen, alles gut?
Yes.
Los hermanos en Brasil. Bom dia. Que Deus te abençoe. That's Portuguese. And Mauricio maybe is listening to us in Italy. Bonjour. Que Deus te benedite, Mauricio. I thank God to be here today, and especially I thank God for my wife who permit me to be here. And I thank Pastor Allen for the hospitality. And just like Jesus, you know, when Jesus was with Martha, Mary, and Lazarus, he feel at home and relax. And one time I was relaxing, you know, on the bed, and Pastor Tom come and take a picture. See? The great invitation today for each one of us. The great invitation of Jesus Christ for us in this morning. We know we are being working very hard. Some are come from many places traveling, and you are tired. And Jesus' invitation in this morning is in Matthew chapter 11, verse 28. Come to me, all who are laboring and are heavy laden, and I will give you what? Rest. Today we need rest. And it is only in Jesus that we can rest.
Amen.
You know, back home we have our health program. We give hydrotherapy, massage, and sometimes some physiotherapy, they come and see me because they are under stress and tension, giving many treatments to people. And when I put them on the massage table, I tell them, rest, relax. And then when I give him the treatment, massage, and I say, just let your head rest in my hand. And most of them can't do that. They are tense. They don't let go. And this morning, many of us could be in tension, stress. And Jesus is calling us, come to me and rest. Let loose. Because stress is one of the big problems in health.
Amen.
Our muscles are on tension, we don't know how to relax, and people have problems because prolonged stress will cause pathologic problems, especially with our muscles. And therefore we need to practice relax. And Jesus is giving us this great invitation in this morning. Come to me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest, peace, rest in Jesus. But how we can do this in practice? How we can go into the sanctuary and receive rest? And in this camp meeting, I was working with the youth, especially Ashley, and I was thinking how we can help young people to understand the sanctuary message and to be prepared for the final atonement. And especially as we open our Bible, we'll look for some verses. Jesus, talking with his disciples, Matthew 20, chapter 19, we go to our Bible, Matthew chapter 19, Jesus and the children. Verse 13. Then were there brought into him little children, that he should put his hands on them and pray. And the disciples rebuked them. But Jesus said, suffer little children, and forbid them not to come into me, for of such is the kingdom of heaven. And I was praying how we can help little children, how we can help the youth to come to Jesus. Steps to Christ in the sanctuary. Steps to Christ. Jesus says, I am the way, the truth, and life. And how the little children can come to Jesus. How they can have sure steps and come to Jesus. And in the sanctuary is where they have to come to Jesus. And if we have the sanctuary service going on here, you can imagine that, the sanctuary service. We have hills around us. If the sanctuary service is going on here, the people who are on the hills, what do you think that they will do? When they see animals were being killed, sacrifices we made, sweet incense, they will come down and see what's going on. What is going on here? What you guys are doing here in the sanctuary? And that is the time to teach them, especially the little children, how to come to Christ, steps to Christ. And then some will come and some will try to step over and jump in. You say, no, wait. We have the door here. You have to come into the door. And the door is Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And when they enter into the door, they say, hey, what is this? Are you making some barbecue here? Maybe some meat you are preparing for us? They say, no, this is the altar, the sacrifice. And here the lamb have to be sacrificed. And who is the lamb? Should we have go and see for some lambs back home? Maybe those who are lambs who have stock, we can buy the lamb and bring it for sacrifices? No. Jesus is the lamb.
Amen.
You don't need to go and look for a lamb anymore. Jesus Christ is the lamb.
Amen.
And then as they move forward, little tears are very curious. What's this? We have water here, it's a swimming pool. Can we just go in and swim a little bit or not? They say, no. This is the fountain of water. What is this? This is the water for regeneration. And then we move to the holy place. And what is in there? In the holy place, children were like, what's that? You have some bread? Can I take this bread and eat it? I say, yes, you can. Because that bread is the word of Jesus. We need to eat. Little children have to have good breakfast in the morning. But before breakfast, you need to have the word of God. You have to eat of the word. And when you eat, you will be strong. And if you eat the word of the God, you will be strong. You will have a strong faith, because faith comes by what? Eating the word. And then the little children say, hey, I see here, look, it's incense. It smells good. What's that? And the children will access. They say, well, there's the prayers that go up to God knows. It's incense, good smell. That's the word of God, that's our thoughts, our prayers. And there's some other things. He said, hey, what is these candles? We have seven candles here. What does this mean? With the children, what is the candles? What answer can you give?
Light of the world.
What keep the candles burning? Oh, there's the Holy Spirit of God. That's important. And then they see the veil and they say, can we go in there and see what's up to the veil? Can we go there? So yes, we can go there. Do you know why? Because when Jesus Christ died on the cross, the veil was open. And then we can see what is in the ark. And what is in the ark? The children will ask. Well, the Ten Commandments. And you know, as you have been walking step by step as little children, obeying Jesus, eating the bread, praying, receiving the Holy Spirit, then you are not the same as before. Now you are a newborn child. You go through the experience of what? You were born again. You were dead in what? In trespasses and sins. But now you are a new creature. And then the children was like, well, yes, it's important. But the law, where the law judges. I'm ready for the law. I'm ready to go before the judge. They have the law. The law is in there. I'm a little bit afraid. It caused a little bit stress. Jesus will say, no, children. Relax. Rest. And go with me in Galatians. Galatians, Jesus will assure us that when we walk, when we take these steps, Galatians chapter 5. When little children obey Jesus and step by step enter to the sanctuary by the door that is Jesus Christ, Jesus then will lead us. We will go to the experience of a newborn child. And then, as Jesus has been teaching us how to walk, Galatians 6:5, verse 16, this I say then, walk in the Spirit, and ye shall not fulfill the lusts of the flesh. Amen. Then little children walk in the Spirit. And what are the fruits of the Spirit? And are those who, little children who walk in the Spirit, are they under the law? Verse 18, chapter 5. But if ye be led of the Spirit, you are not under the law. And you don't need to worry, you don't need to be afraid, you don't need to be stressed to go for the final atonement. And what are the fruit of the spirits? Verse 22, little children, youth, steps to Christ in sanctuary, step by step. Verse 22, but the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, long-suffering, gentleness, goodness, faith, meekness, verse 23, temperance. Against such there is no law. Then we are prepared for this final atonement. Little children can be prepared in a simple way for the final atonement. I am addressing to the little children. Today I am not speaking with the adults, the fathers and the mothers, I'm sorry. But if the little children can understand the sanctuary, you guys, the fathers, can understand it. Is that true?
Amen.
And the little children are going to do a great work in these last days, and God going to use the children. Therefore, Jesus said, let they come to me. And we have to pray for our children today, that they can be instruments in God's hand to finish the work. And as we prepare for the communion service, steps to Christ, Just as these little children has followed Jesus into the sanctuary, steps to Christ to experience the newborn experience, to walk in spirit, so we also can walk in spirit. And to prepare for the Lord's Supper, Galatians 5. We have to prepare our heart. We have to let loose of things that are not of the Spirit. And what are these things that are not of the Spirit? Verses 19 and 20. Now the works of the flesh are manifest, which are these: adultery, fornication, uncleanness, lasciviousness. Verse 20. Idolatry, witchcraft, hatred, variance, emulations, wrath, strife, seductions, heresies, envy, murders, drunkenness, violence, and such like, after which I tell you before, as I have also tell you in time past, that they which do such things shall not inherit the kingdom of God. So, when we are preparing for the Lord's Supper, we have to be sure that we pass through the sanctuary and all these works of the flesh, Jesus can wash them with His blood and in the water. Because when we pierce Jesus Christ, what come out of His body? Blood and water. To cleanse us from our sins, all our sins with the blood. And the water will regenerate us, restoring redemption. And this is the message today for the young and for old. May God help us that we can walk in spirit. And as we move forward for the communion service, may God help us, each one of us, to rest in Jesus. Let loose all these things that are not of the Spirit. And walk in the Spirit. May God bless each one of us in this morning with this message. Shall we kneel down for a word of prayer? Our Heavenly Father, we pray, Lord, that you will give us a heart, just as the children, to come with a childlike faith to Jesus. That we can let loose to everything that is fruit of the flesh, and that, Lord, that you will help us to go to the sanctuary, and that you will cleanse us, that you will regenerate us, and Father, that we can have the fruits of the Spirit, this love, joy, peace, long-suffering. Against these things there is no law. We pray, Lord, that your peace and your blessing and that your Holy Spirit will rest upon us and help us to prepare for the communion service, and that you will bless us, and that we can go out from here sharing Jesus Christ with our brothers and sisters and all over the world. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen.